Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel.
And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
So today's video is going to be my empties for the month of December. So I have quite a few things in here, so I think we're just gonna go ahead and get started. So I'm gonna start with all the like Bath and Body Works stuff. And by the way, I'm sorry if you can hear my brother in the background, he's developing film today. So he's going crazy in the bathroom, and then there's a million cars on the freeway because it is January 1st and everybody's off. So anyways, let's get started with the Bath and Body Works stuff. So we finished up two hand soaps, one in our downstairs bathroom and one in my bathroom upstairs. This is Harvest Gathering, which we finished in my bathroom. It's fresh picked apples, autumn berries, and clove buds. I started this, I think, at the end of November, and we finished it about a week ago. I think we finished it on Christmas Day. So, and it's like super strong. It just, honestly, it smells kind of like how autumn the candle smells. So it smells really good. And I like this for like a November scent. So it was really nice for the time that we used it. And then in the downstairs bathroom, we used up apples and brown sugar, which I had this one last year too. It's kind of dirty, sorry. The notes are baked apples, brown sugar, and flaky pie crust. It smells so good. It literally just smells like the inside of an apple pie. It smells awesome. So I definitely love these two. I love these two and the formula of them. They're Creamy Luxe. I love the Creamy Luxe hand soap, so those two are really nice. We finished up a few pocket backs. I finished Marshmallow Pumpkin Latte, and I actually really loved this scent. I had it in my, I have like a pocket back holder that goes on the side of my purse, and so it just dangles there, and it's like covered, the label's covered, so I didn't know what the flavor, what the scent was, and it was Marshmallow Pumpkin Latte. And I didn't even know that I liked this scent, so I might have to get more things in this next year, like a hand soap or something, because I know I don't like the body care, but I really liked how the hand sanitizer smelled. So I might get more things in Marshmallow Pumpkin Latte next year. And then my mom finished off, well, me and my mom combined finished off Stay Magical Unicorn Petals. We got this at Summer SAS in 2020. So, I mean, it's just like a nice floral scent. It's not too strong because we usually don't like florals, but it wasn't that strong, so we could still use it. And then from my project Use It Up, I finished Sweet Cinnamon Pumpkin in the body cream. And as you know, I cut these open. You definitely want to cut them open because you can get quite a few more uses out of them. I scraped it all off the bottom, like I got every drop of this, and I really don't like Sweet Cinnamon Pumpkin in the body care, so now I know I don't have to buy it again. But yeah, I really liked it though for like October when I was like heavily using it. October, November, when I was like heavily using it. It was really nice, but I don't particularly like that scent. And then I finished off these two travel size minis from 2016 in Twisted Peppermint, the shower gel and the body lotion, and figured out that I like Twisted Peppermint. So I actually bought it in the lotion, I think at the body care day sale or something. So that was really nice. Glad that I finished those up because they were getting very old. I have something that I kind of decluttered. It's this body loofah sponge thing. It's like a scrubber for your body from Earth Therapeutics. I got this from Ulta, but it was getting so dirty and gross, and it's like very crusty and crunchy, and so I was like, let me get a new one. So I actually bought a new one from Marshall's, not the same brand, but the same kind of scrubber deal. So I'm decluttering this one. Just it's lived its life. I probably had it for like 5 or 6 months, so I need to get rid of that anyways. The next thing that I'm also kind of just getting rid of because it's too old is the Evolve. I don't even know what this is called, but it's like a teasing brush or like a smoothing brush. I used this with some hairspray, basically the same thing I did today, but I used a new one. I just bought a new one from Marshall's, I think is where I found it. I haven't been able to find these at all where they usually sell them, which is Walmart. I've had this for probably 6 years, and it's just so gross. But usually I'll spray my hair down with hairspray and then I'll smooth it kind of with a brush like this. So I love this brush. I'm just decluttering it because it's so old and I got a replacement. So sorry y'all, forgot about this Bath & Body Works empty Mary Cookie in the hand cream. I loved this scent. It smelled so good. I really enjoyed using it. As you guys know, I love the hand creams from Bath & Body Works. I pretty much use up one a month, so I really loved this and I already bought a new one from SAS. And if you haven't seen my haul, go watch it because I got some really good stuff. The next thing is another hair product. It's the Away, I think is how you say it. Way or Away, I'm not sure. The Rose Hair and Body Oil. So I use this as a hair oil, kind of when I straighten my hair, I would use this, but I couldn't really get out the last bit of it, but that's okay. I liked it, I liked how it smelled, but it's just a little sample. I don't need to buy a full size of that. I have a lot of hair oils still that I need to get through. The next thing I have is the Garnier Fructis Sleek and Shine Hairspray. This is my absolute favorite hairspray. I love it. I really love it because I can brush my hair out like the night after using this and it doesn't leave my hair crunchy or greasy or flaky with like those flakes of hairspray that sometimes you get. So yeah, I really, really love this one. I use number 4 Stronghold, Ultra Stronghold. So yeah, I really, really like this hairspray. I have a few more I have to get through before I'll buy another one, but I do plan on buying another one. And then we have some skincare empties. So I got through a Mary Kay Clear Proof Blemish Control Toner with Salicylic Acid. It's just a little mini one of it, and I would use this kind of after I popped my pimples or on my pimples, just kind of like as a toner to kind of get rid of them, and it feels really nice when you put it on there, so love that. I do already have a full size of it. I was just getting through that mini. I finished this little lip balm from, Bubble Tea Cosmetics. It's a lip balm in lemongrass and green tea. This, I think I got it in an Ipsy bag a few years back and I just had it and I didn't know how to use it, but I use this after I brush my teeth in the morning or at night and I got through the whole thing. It's very satisfying to look at, to see it all empty like that. And I realized that I do like using like pot lip balms after I brush my teeth. So it was actually really nice to figure that out. And then I also finished up a little EOS chapstick. I've been going through lip balms like crazy lately, so finished up those two. And then I also finished up these Clear Fit Master Patches from COSRX. I love these pimple patches. I have multiple. I have a backup coming in the mail from Ulta, and it's gonna be the Clear Fit and the Regular Fit. So they have a Clear Fit one that you can wear like in the daytime and you can put makeup over it and you can't really tell that it's even there. It's so thin, but I really, really love these pimple patches. They work wonders, especially if you have like the little underground pimples. God, those are annoying. Or like they'll pop and then they'll still keep filling up the next few days. But if you put those pimple patches on it, it'll kind of prevent that from happening. So I really love pimple patches. I've been really liking them for my maskne. I never used to have like, cystic acne. I never used to get that, but ever since I've been wearing a mask daily, I've been getting them a lot more often, and it's usually like right here, so that's how I know it's from my mask. So that's been really kind of bad, but pimple patches have been saving me. And then the next few things I have are actually declutters, just because they got too old and I had to get rid of them. So the first thing is the Stila Glitter and Glow in the shade Kitten Karma. I really, really love these. I think I got this in like maybe 2018. So it lasted me 2 years before it dried out on me, but it just got too dry and I can't use it anymore. And I don't really feel like reviving it with like eye drops or something, because I feel like that's not good for your eyes. Like a liquid eye product you probably shouldn't be using for more than 2 years anyways. So it's totally fine that I have to get rid of it. The next thing is a OPI nail lacquer. This is a mini. I don't even know what the shade is, but it started getting all separated like this. And then it's all gloopy. So if you open it, it's all gloopy. So I know that it's definitely bad by now. And then the last thing is the Essence Extreme Lasting Eye Pencil in Silky Nude. I really loved this when I had it. It's going on 4 years old, I think. So really you should not have an eye pencil for that long. And it wasn't applying as easily as it used to. It's like definitely dried out. I barely even used it a lot. Like maybe it was like right here when I bought it. But yeah, I definitely don't think you should have eye pencils, things that go near your eye for more than 4 years. So I'm definitely decluttering that. I have a backup, let me actually show you guys. I got this at Marshall's. It is a Pixie Endless Silky Eye Pencil in the shade Matte Nude. This went on like a dream. That I had kind of like forgotten how eye pencils were supposed to apply because this one's so old. Let me show you guys how easily this goes on. like, what? I used this today. And I really, really love how it looks. So let's compare the two and how easily that would, see this one I have to like push down a little bit. And it's almost a different color too. Like this is like way whiter than this one is. And I like that this one's not as white, because if I'm gonna use it on my waterline, I don't want it to be white. I have a white eye pencil that I would use if I wanted to. So anyways, yeah, this was like $3.99, I think, at Marshall's. So very good deal. I love Pixie. I was actually gonna buy this anyways from Ulta for I think $12. So very happy to have that. But yeah, that is everything that I used up for the month of December. Not a lot of Bath & Body Works, but I did get through some pretty old stuff that I was worried about, you know, going bad on me. So I'm very happy to have those things out of my collection and to have finished those off before they went bad. So that's everything that I have for today's video. If you liked this, please like this video and comment down below. It really helps out. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.